The vehicle industry is changing dramatically. We are effectively removing fossil fuel internal combustion engines. The UK has got an aim to do this by 2030. Now that's really good from an air quality point of view, but we solve one problem and we don't completely eliminate another one. Microplastics are tiny pieces of synthetic chemicals, which we term plastic, but they're defined as being less than 5 millimeters in any diameter. We're still at the very beginning of asking a number of health-related questions around microplastics.
Microplastics are believed to be more toxic than larger pieces of plastic, and that's because of their small size. There's many reasons why microplastics are a problem. We believe they're very persistent, so once they're in the environment, it takes a really long time for them to break down, if they ever break down fully at all. And because of their small size, it means that they can enter cells, potentially accumulate in the body and cause harm.
It's estimated that we eat about a credit card's worth of plastic a week in our food, which is a really scary thought. I'm Siobhan. I'm one of the 4 co-founders at the Tyre Collective, and I lead research and development. We were originally just looking at microplastics in general, but the more we kept reading about the problem, the issue of tire wear kept coming up again and again, and it really caught our interest. Tires wear down every time you accelerate, brake, and corner, and that dust being produced enters our air and it enters our water. It's the second largest microplastic pollutant.
The move towards more environmentally friendly vehicles is of concern for microplastic and tyre dust concentrations in the environment, because these are generally heavier. The heavier the vehicle, the more dust it creates.
We decide that we need to try and build something to address this.
I was reading the daily newsletter which the college puts out. One of the things that were reported was on this student competition. It had been won by a group of students called the Tyre Collective. I had been having this light bulb moment about the need to understand more about tyres and microbeads and plastics which are coming from that source. It was a marriage made in heaven.
We all met at our master's course, which is Innovation Design Engineering at the Royal College of Art and Imperial College London. We have a really wide variety of backgrounds. Mine is in kinesiology and biology. Hansen's is in architecture. Deepak's is in interaction design. Hugo is a mechanical engineer. The Tyre Collective is an innovation company that is working on developing a device that can collect tire wear pollution right at the source, at the wheel arch, before it can get out into the environment. Currently, we have a working lab prototype, and we are working on scaling up our technology to a full-size device.
So what you see here is our working prototype. This rig is designed to mimic a vehicle skidding or constantly turning. Through our early experiments, we found that the tyre particles are actually charged due to friction with the road, and therefore we can use electrostatics to attract and deflect these charged particles. At the moment, it's an array of copper plates, and the particles are generated at a contact patch where they fly off and then adhere to the plates themselves. We can clean them off and store them in a removable storage unit where we can then process them and use them in a variety of applications.
We are also really interested in looking at how we can reuse this material to help create a circular business model.
If we had standards which ensured that a tire would last for so long and would not release toxic products, then of course society would be much safer as a consequence. But we're not at that point yet, either from the research side, from a health viewpoint, or from the tire industry having to adhere to a standard.
I think especially if there's anything that we've learned over this past year is how much we are linked to our planet and our Earth. And anything that we do put out there, any pollution source, even though we don't think that it'll have a direct effect on us, it does come back to us in some form.
There's a lot of great researchers out there. There is a lot of papers coming out. It's growing exponentially. Plastic, everyone's really latched onto it. I think it's something that's really tangible and accessible and people get it.
I am hopeful for the future. If you asked me that question 10 years ago, I would have said no. But I do think that things have changed. I think we're on the road to change, to being a better society.
For every challenge, there's a group of thinkers out there with an idea for a solution.